by rising gas prices, because that money's got to go somewhere.
This show is sponsored. It's sponsored by Sid Frank. Yes, hello, Johnson's residence.
Hello, Tony. Tony, look, I'll get you the money by Monday, Tony. Don't you worry, Tony. You wouldn't kill a man on Sunday, would you? You're a man of God, Tony. Tony, I got a wife and family, Tony. Tony, you would respect a man on Sunday, wouldn't you, Tony? Hey, Tony, I promise I'll get you the money by Monday,
hey,
Tony.
Hey, who the hell is Tony?
What do you mean, you're not Tony?
Goddamn telemarketers. Yes, hello, Johnson's residence.
Hey, Tony. It was a real smooth job, Tony. You would have loved it, Tony. Tony took a nice vacation on the Hudson River, Tony. Outfitted him with a nice pair of concrete boots. Oh, it was real slick. Just the kind of job you like. It makes you smile.
You killed him.
Well, yeah, you asked me to, didn't you?
It's time I signed up for USO. What do you want?
Oh my God, Tony, why have you not been calling me? It has been weeks, hon. Are you going to the wedding on Sunday? Oh my gosh, it is going to be gorgeous.
Jesus fucking Mary, who the hell are you? Why do you keep calling me?
Tony, dear, we dated for like a day.
Yes, hello, Johnson's residence.
Tony, you better move out of our turf. All right, you've got 3 days getting your stupid face out of our turf, or else bad things are gonna happen. All right, you keep that in mind, Tony. You just get on out of here, all right?
What are you gonna do to me?
Just you wait, Tony.
Why is this happening to me?
What do you want?
You got a wife, Tony. You got kids.
You mean Riley and little Jackson?
You love them, Tony. We try to protect the people we love, Tony, but we can't always protect the people we love. You know, your kids walk home from school. You can't always stay safe. Anything can happen on the way home from school, Tony.
Hi, we've been trying to reach you about your car's extended warranty.
Today's show is sponsored by Legos. We're here to make sure that you have chronic foot pain.
Now we've got the studio ready out for the rest of the day, and that's it because our budget is blown.
Now you have one job, one chance to get this right. Okay. Silence amplifies the depression in modern teenagers. So I want you to be quiet. If I hear so much as a foot tap, or a blink, or a sneeze, or a cough, you will be off the stage and you will never act again. Do I make myself clear? All right. Scene 4, Eden dances. Action.
Oh my god.
Okay, next one. Question two. Who
clue Abraham Lincoln. A, a woman.
B, a man.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
C, a bullet.
Too soon.
D, all of the above.
He was married to a woman, and he was shot by a man.
Gotta be D.
Oh, D.
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 Yeah.
Last question is free response.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah. We can do it.
Yes. Name the rhetorical device used in the following passage.
Let's read it all together.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Okay. Okay. I did not have sexual relations with that woman.
Relations?
Woman?
No, you know what? Right. D, all of the above.
Let's go! As Monica Wazowski once said, no child left behind.
We're going to college!
Sponsored by a certain local high school, without whom half of these kids would not be possible.
So, on today's administrative meeting, we do have the drug issue in the back.
Oh, see, we cannot use that word.
Issue.
No.
Yeah, so we have to use 5%.
Okay. So today's meeting is on the 5% dilemma in the bathroom. And I was thinking we need to find some solutions to stop this from happening. Mm-hmm. Now, personally, I suggest a non-invasive method of giving each kid a sticker book. And every 20 minutes, a teacher comes in and shouts, "Are you part of the 5%? And if they say no, they get a sticker. And whoever has the most stickers gets a bigger sticker.
Okay. I hear you. However, it is high school. So in my opinion, I feel like if a student would like to go to the bathroom or leave the class in general, they have to get a hall pass, walk outside to the track, run the mile under 6 minutes, and then they can go to the bathroom.
Outer ring.
And this not only will create a competition if a student would like to empty their system, but would also raise our health and fitness.
That's
true.
My kids are so
fat. Any other ideas?
Well, I like all your ideas, I really do, but I feel like we need to administer more of a surveillance over our kiddos, more of a watchful eye. So we administer, follow me on this, electronic anklets. You put them on kids, doesn't have to be consensual, keep that in mind.
They are in the school.
Right, they don't have
We them. Have control of them.
Essentially, yes. And so if they're outside the classroom for, let's say, 4 minutes, it lets out an ear-piercing alarm that notifies everybody in the neighborhood, including all faculty.
Mm-hmm. Now, there is one issue. I was looking over our budget for the year, and all of it went to boys' lacrosse again.
Because we have never funded any other boys' sport at this school.
And also, they're going to make it to quarterfinals this year.
I believe in them.
I suggest that instead of doing ankle bracelets, as you said, expensive, instead say that we remove stall doors so then students can check if other students are in fact part of the 5%.
Citizens arrest.
It also promotes social interaction.
It does feel a little invasive. So I'm thinking we get, my initial thought before Beatrice crunched the numbers on this was that we get a drug dog.
Oh, yes.
But we can't afford one.
No.
So for the 95%, to encourage education and kindness for them, I think we get another, like a therapy animal of sorts, a dog. But again, yeah. The numbers, we can't afford training for it. So does anyone here have a pet that they
I do have. I have one of those hairless cats.
No hair, no allergies, allergies, we pay the nurse.
And more money to boys lacrosse. She's named Crayola.
Perfect. All right, well, I'll make the announcement now. Good morning, unnamed high school. This is your principal redacted speaking to you over the fire alarm system as our loudspeakers and bells are still broken. To help the 95% of you who are adhering to school policy around our values, education, and kindness. Because if there are two things we value here at Unnamed High School, that would be education and kindness. But only for the 95% of you that are not delinquents. We have administered a new policy regarding a therapy animal to help the 95% of you with your education and your kindness. We have a hairless cat named Crayola. Same day, we will go mask optional, which won't cause problems at all. And Crayola, the hairless cat, will add to our school's warm, welcoming, safe, and fuzzy-less atmosphere. Welcome Crayola when he comes to school on Monday. Go flying lizards and have a safe day full of education and kindness.
They don't really make you mad. Other things just make you swear and curse.
Oh, son of a bitch!
When you're chewing on life's gristle.
Give a whistle.
This will help things turn out for the best. And always look on the bright side of life.
Last laugh is on you. And always look up.
Ha 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 ha!